Bank of America just came out with a new mortgage program that makes it a lot easier to qualify for a mortgage. And a lot of people will have a lot of questions about it, comparing it to programs in 2008. And it's a really lax program, especially with how the housing market is existing right now with increasing home values and increasing interest rates. Its goal is to make access to mortgages and homeownership easier, but it's drawing a lot of questions, especially amidst, you know, Bank of America is still dealing with a $2.7 billion lawsuit from 2008 housing crash. And the bond insurer on this lawsuit is arguing that they systematically approved shoddy mortgages and pushed the risk onto investors and insurers. So I want to explain this program. If this is a program you want to take advantage of, I have no affiliation with Bank of America. I have not talked with them. I just want to explain what's out there and what we know so far, so you can make a wise choice on if you want it. So it's called the Community Affordable Loan Solution. Big key points: 0% down, $0 down. Another kicker: $0 closing cost. Now, there are a lot of other zero down mortgages, things like USDA loans, you have VA loans, and then you also have a lot of down payment assistance programs with conventional FHA loans that can offer 0% down. What's different here is that there are no closing costs. Likely what is going to be included are things like prepaid items. So like your homeowner's insurance likely is going to be included in that. That's usually not a closing cost item. Or taxes, those are likely going to be included here. It's unclear if Bank of America is going to give a credit. But with most programs that offer 0% down, usually you still expect to pay closing costs. This program is saying that you don't have to. Also, there's no PMI, which is the monthly mortgage insurance, private mortgage insurance, that is usually put on loans that have less than 20% down to protect the lender against a default. Now, something interesting that they're doing here is no minimum credit score. Usually for a conventional loan, you're going to expect a 620 minimum FICO credit score. With FHA loans, you're going to expect the actual minimum is 500, but most lenders usually are around 580. Now, what they do is they're going to use what's more common on what are called manually underwritten loans, which are loans that are viewed with a little bit more scrutiny. And what they do is instead of looking at your credit score, which arguably isn't the best indicator of if you can pay back a mortgage, they're going to use your rent history, utility history, phone history, and any other kind of bills like that to build up a profile to see, do you repay back expenses or things like rent? Okay. And again, this is common with manual underwriting. And so that's what they're going to be doing here instead of using a credit score. Now, this is only for first-time homebuyers. Okay. And a first-time homebuyer is someone who has not been on the title to a home in the past 3 years. Now, this is where things are getting a little bit tricky, and we're seeing a lot of people having mixed feelings about this program. Now, this is a pilot program. They're just testing this in certain markets, but this is directly from Bank of America. They said this is available in designated markets, including certain Black, African American, and or Hispanic Latino neighborhoods in Charlotte, Dallas, Detroit, LA, and Miami. Okay, so this is not available all over the place yet. This is just a test program happening in these neighborhoods. Okay, and they're likely going to be using the census tract to determine these neighborhoods. Now, one key note here is this is not for one ethnic or racial group. This is for primarily the neighborhood. So this is for all borrowers, but it's going to be based on your income and the location of the home. Okay. Now, also, this is primary residence only. You can't buy an investment property with this. So some of the requirements here, you still do have to qualify with your income. Okay. Even though it's 0% down, no closing costs, no PMI, you still will have to actually be able to afford it. Bank of America hasn't said what those your requirements are, but it's likely they're going to be using the debt to income ratio. This is the same ratio that almost every other loan uses to determine if you can pay back a loan. I'm going to estimate it's probably going to be around 45%. Bank of America has not said anything about this yet. So you can take your monthly gross income times 0.45. That's a maximum amount of debt you have or you're allowed to have. So you subtract your monthly debts. So if you have a $300 car loan, you know, a $200 credit card payment, you subtract that from that number. What's left over is the maximum mortgage payment you can have. Okay. Also, there's no clear loan limit. Most loans have a limit on how much or how big of a loan you can take out. They haven't said anything here. If it's going off of what other, you know, grants Bank of America has, likely they're going to be using a conventional loan and following conventional loan limits, which right now for most of the US is $647,200, which gives you a maximum purchase price of $667,000. With 0% down, you're going to be stuck with the $647,200. Okay. One other requirement is you do have to complete a homebuyer certification course. This is not that significant. This is homebuyer certification courses are required on a lot of loans, and it'll probably take you 30 minutes to an hour to go through. It is free. If it does have a cost, it's going to be a very minimal cost, and usually that's going to be covered. So it may be helpful, but you'll probably learn a lot more by doing your own independent research than just relying on a homebuyer certification course. So why are they offering this program? Well, first of all, Bank of America makes money. I'll explain that a little bit later. They obviously make money off of this program. They're not just doing this out of goodwill, right? Banks aren't operating, you know, for-profit companies are not operating out of goodwill, even if it, you know, may seem like that. Okay. No one's under that illusion here. So there's an interesting report by the National Association of Realtors where they say the home ownership amount of white households was 72% in 2020, according to National Association of Realtors, compared to 51% for Hispanic and 43% for Black households. And so this program is targeted at closing the home ownership gap here. Okay. Also, Black borrowers are denied at twice the rate of overall borrowers from a Lending Tree report. So that's the main goal here. Again, this is not just out of goodwill. Obviously, Bank of America is making money with us. Okay. And so there's a couple things here in which why I think Bank of America is likely offering a program like this. Okay. As a bank, banks can often create loss leader products, basically where they're not making money on a certain product because they have other ones they can sell. Bank of America, for instance, if you get a mortgage through them through a program like this, maybe they don't make money on the mortgage. Okay. But they, you know, there's a lot of people who get a mortgage with Bank of America who likely will use their depository accounts like checking and savings, or they may get a home equity loan, or they may get a car loan. They may get a, you know, credit card. They may get a personal loan. There's other products that they can sell. And so this is really common with physicians' loans, where banks will often give loans for doctors and basically not really make any money on the mortgage, but they want that client because that doctor usually is going to be worth a lot of money to them with other products that they have. So that's one thing here. Likely, there's probably going to be a higher interest rate. I don't know that for certain. None of that's published online, but usually what happens with these programs is they do tend to have a higher interest rate than a more traditional loan product to make up for the risk. So it's something to be aware of, and you can shop around for as well. Okay. Now, what's in it for you? All right. Obviously, easier access to appreciating real estate. You know, right now, the recording of this video, real estate is up 15% year over year. And it's been like that, a double digit growth for the past couple years. Will that continue in the future? It's really difficult to say. Nobody knows what the future is going to look like. A lot of people are expecting things to slow down. Some people are even expecting things to flip in the other direction. Nobody knows for certain. However, historically, real estate does appreciate over time. So this could be easier access to get into a home if that's what you're looking for. Obviously, though, with the caveat that you need to do this and be very careful about jumping into something just because it's easy. All right. If it's easy, that opens yourself to risk if you're not familiar with some of the ins and outs and what to be careful of, which I'm going to talk about on the next slide. $0 out of pocket, I actually think is really great. I know a lot of people like really shame $0 down programs, and they're like, oh, if you can't afford the down payment, then you shouldn't buy a house. While I do believe that's true, I don't think it's a full thought. Okay. So for instance, if you have no money in your bank account, you should not be buying a house. Okay. If you don't have money to buy any, you know, to pay for any part of the house, I don't think you should buy a house. However, let's say that you're buying a home and you actually do have, let's say you have $20,000 saved up, and then you happen to find a $0 down program. I think that's a better solution. Have the $20,000 in cash that you can use for potential repairs, emergency fund, moving expenses, you know, paint, furniture, everything down here, without having to put it into the equity of the home where you can't access it, right? You have that $20,000 in cash, I think is a lot more effective and a lot more safe than putting it on the down payment. So if you have money, I think the zero down payment you know, the zero down programs are actually pretty helpful in allowing you to have free cash. The opposite though, and I will say one more note on that, I see so many people who do have money saved up and then they will go wipe out their bank account to buy a home. So they bought a home and they put a down payment down, but they don't have any money left in their bank account for things like moving expenses, emergencies, and the things that come up with owning a home. So obviously, if you don't have any money, if you're like, I can't afford a down payment, I don't think going with a 0% down program is smart, because buying a home, owning a home, does come with expenses that will add up extremely quickly. Okay. So my main questions, concerns here, how much higher is the interest rate? Is it going to be higher? We don't know what that's going to be like yet. You need to shop that around, talk to multiple lenders to see, is that rate high? You know, talk with Bank of America and then talk with other lenders to see what kind of interest rate you could get. Also, a higher rate, if it does have a higher rate, could set people up for failure. This is what a lot of people have some concerns about, is that since they're targeting these specific neighborhoods, is that if you're offering programs that then have a higher monthly cost, it's not just the higher monthly cost, but it's the interest cost over time. So for instance, if you're getting, let's say, a $400,000 loan, and we're gonna exclude taxes and insurance for this, but if you're getting a $400,000 loan, just the principal and interest payment is gonna be almost $2,400 per month at a 6% interest rate. At a 7% interest rate, it's $263 per month more, okay? Over 10 years, that adds up to $40,000 in interest. Over 30 years, that's $95,000 in interest that you pay extra just because of that 1% increase in rate. And so this is the big frustration or big concern I think a lot of people have, where it's, if you're offering these programs that seem really interesting in the beginning, but they do have a higher rate, this is $40,000 less in somebody's pocket, or $95,000 less in somebody's pocket over 10 years, 30 years, because of that higher rate. So something to be mindful of. Also, how long do you have to stay in the home? Sometimes these programs do have a limit on, you know, or say you have to be in the home for, let's say, 3 years, 5 years. They're unclear on that at the moment. It may just be that there is no requirement to stay in the home. Is there an income limit? That is not clear yet. And then one thing, the biggest concern is the equity risk. With every 0% down program, there is a risk of equity, because if your home right now is valued here and you have 0% down, you have no equity in it. That means if you wanted to sell and you used a realtor and you're paying 6% for both realtors, you know, 3% to one realtor, 3% to the other, which is common, you're gonna have to pay money to be able to sell your home, okay? So if home values go sideways or down, you may be underwater in your mortgage, where you owe more than your home is worth. Or the opposite could happen. The home could appreciate, which has happened historically over time, but it's going to take a lot longer for you to have the equity to be able to sell. Okay, so you may have to hold on to that home longer, whereas if you did have a down payment, you do have some more freedom to sell if you need to in a pinch. Okay, so something to be careful of with these 0% down programs. If you are considering using a program like this, again, you would talk to Bank of America. Don't talk to me. We don't do this program. So Bank of America, please make sure you have reserves. Do not buy this program if you do not have money. Owning a home comes with expenses. Things break and you will need to pay for them. You don't want to have to put that onto something like a credit card or just not be able to pay for it at all. So what I think is ideal is 3 to 6 months of expenses, depending on how risky you like to live. And basically the way this works is, if your monthly mortgage payment is $1,000 per month, 3 months of expenses is $3,000. If your mortgage payment is $2,000 per month, 3 months of expenses is $6,000. Okay. Have that in the bank. That's going to give you a nice cushion and protection if things happen. All right. Also, explore Bank of America's other programs. Bank of America funds the NACA program, which is a program that also provides very similar features as this loan, but it takes a lot longer. You have to go through counseling and budget it, you know, budget with a NACA counselor. I think there's also some community service involved in there as well. So it's something to look into. Bank of America also has other grant programs for you to explore. And then also, explore other traditional programs like conventional loans, FHA loans. And if you want to get a quote, I have a link in the description. I can connect you with a loan officer who can help you through that process. Now, this is only part of the story though, because this is only one of the grant programs that Bank of America has. Bank of America actually has several other grant programs. And if you want to learn more about their other grant program, click on this video here to see if that one's better for you.